Hi everyone, my name is Beatriz La Puente and I work as Communication Manager at ICCRAM, the International Research Center of the University of Burgos. At this chapter, I will try to bring you closer to this field by explaining the keys of the management of the communication and dissemination activities within European research projects. In addition, we will go through some points to be considered at the time of elaborating your communication and dissemination plan. First of all, we must see the difference between communication and dissemination without forgetting that exploitation is also related to this part. If you want to go deeper into the exploitation part, I recommend that you look at the previous chapter. In general terms, communication is the action of promoting your results and activities related to the project from the start until the end of it, addressing a general public. While dissemination consists of making your results available in up to 4 years after the end of the project, addressing technical audiences. Regarding the audiences, it's important to know who is the information for in order to correctly elaborate the message. Communication must be done in such a way that the general public gets the message. Here we are talking about citizens, media, and the specific stakeholders of its project, as industry or policymakers. The main purpose will be to create awareness about the importance of science and also about the importance of your research. You must transform the technical knowledge into relevant information to non-expert audiences. On the other side, dissemination addresses technical audiences, including those who can benefit from their results. The way to elaborate the message is different because we don't have to transform the content. We just have to make our results public. Why we should communicate and disseminate our work? This is simple. On the one hand, communication shows how results contribute to everyday lives, creating a common knowledge of what we are doing. This is also important because it's a social responsibility. And at the same time, we are showing the success of the European collaboration. On the other hand, dissemination maximizes results impact and allow other researchers to go a step forward, making the scientific results a common good. This is related to the EU's principle of open science, which we will see later. In this picture, you can see more clearly communication plays a role in the funding of EU research projects. It's the factor that brings the different stakeholders together. The opinion of civil society, including organizations and customers, matters and is directly related to the decisions of the European Union, which is responsible for legislation and funding of innovation initiatives. Funding enables the launch of better products and services for that society, creating a feedback loop. For that, it's important to enhance your visibility and attract the best students and experts that collaborate with your research. And how we should do it? As you can see here, there are different tools and channels. The main tools for communicating are the project website, the social media, newsletter, events, and press release. Press releases are important to attract the attention of media, especially local media, who are more likely to be interested in what you do. They should be written to highlight a new development or achievement relevant to society or at least to your own institution. And some of these tools are also useful to disseminate. On the project website, you can upload informative articles, but also you can upload your scientific papers in the same way that you can use social media, newsletter, or the audiovisual content. Actually, the more audiovisual you are, the more impact you will have. Videos and promotional material are one of the best ways to engage your audience. Regarding dissemination, your results must be published in scientific magazines and you should share them in scientific conferences or any event where you have the chance to do it. Also, it is EU obligation to share your data in public repositories, as the nodo or the project website, for example, and accomplish the principles of the fair data management. This is important. Fair means findable, accessible, interoperable and reusable. The principles to be followed to optimize the reuse of data and increase the dissemination of your research. I leave you in the complementary information a very interesting chapter about this topic, given by another Surfbio partner. To complement, the European Commission has its own tools to help with the communication, dissemination, and exploitation of the projects. These are some of them, but I would like to highlight CORDIS, the Community Research and Development Information Service. It's the European Commission's primary source of results from the projects funded by the EU's programs. CORDIS has a public repository with all project information, such as project participants, reports, deliverables, and links to open access publications. Apart from that, I would also like to highlight the use of the artificial intelligence possibilities. This technology has come to change everything, so we must take advantage of it. Some of the benefits of these tools are the efficiency in the generation of web content and social media, as well as the optimization of promotional campaigns. Take a look if you think you need it. In this point, it's time to move on to the communication and dissemination plan, which is compulsory to include in your project proposal, and it should be considered at the drafting stage. So some tips. Bear in mind that communication deals with all work packages, which requires good internal communication and coordination. I would recommend to analyze the link of your project with larger initiatives for a bigger impact. You can use general topics to engage non-scientific audience as circular economy, industrial transformation, green mobility. And then you should ensure a good visual identity with an attractive logo, an attractive website, and audiovisual content to easily attract your target audience. And finally, the most important, you should define your communication and dissemination strategy, taking into account all that we have explained in this chapter. Speaking of which, these are some keys to do it. First, set your goals and objectives. Make clear what you want to achieve with your communication strategy and point out which are your challenges. Then define your audience for communication, include all relevant target groups and tailor your content to each audience. Then adapt your messages. As we said before, you must transform the technical knowledge into relevant information to non-expert audiences. Also, use channels that will reach your target audience. About social media, for example, pick the right social networks. Nowadays, I would recommend LinkedIn and Twitter. And remember to evaluate your impact. It's obligatory to set indicators, KPIs, to measure your success. For dissemination, you should respect the EU's open science policy. Open science is a policy priority for the European Commission as it improves the quality, efficiency, and the response capacity of their research. That's why the Commission requires beneficiaries to make their publications available in open access and make their data as open as possible and as close as necessary. This policy is still being developed, but for the time being, it requires research data to be fair and open by default, as we saw before. It wants to promote the adoption of open science practices, including citizen science, and the development of new indicators for evaluation research. And it focuses on the European Open Science Cloud development. This is an environment where European researchers, innovators, companies, citizens will be able to publish, find, and reuse data, tools, and services for research, innovation, and educational purposes. This is an overview, but you can find more information in the additional resource folder. Finally, it's very important that you are aware of this mandatory requirement, the acknowledgement of the EU funding. The visibility of the European flag and the funding statement is a legal obligation of Horizon Europe Grant Agreement. Therefore, do not forget to add it to all the results, activities, or communication and dissemination actions that you carry out within a European funded project. That's all from my side. I hope you have enjoyed and learned with this chapter and the whole MOOC. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to let us know. You can contact us through the Surfbio website or through our social networks. Thank you very much for your attention.